Hey everybody, welcome to another YouTube video. Today we are going to be playing the Morrigan. The beach. Why half? I'm against Xing Tian, no way. I'm against Xing Tian? Oh man, I don't want to fight Xing Tian. But oh well, I just wanted to play a different god. And I enjoy playing Morrigan a lot because most of the time you can't get a bad matchup with her. Just because whatever god they are, you can be that god as well. Any of those tiny spandex briefs, I'm out. But I like playing the Morrigan. She's fun, she's viable, and there's a lot you could do. One thing that I wanted to show you guys, because a lot of people don't know this, and I get asked a lot on my stream, is for her ult, right? Is that I thought it was kind of common knowledge, but it's not. So what you could do is you can put it on instant cast, and to select a god, you hold your ultimate button and right click on the god you want to transform into, right? And that means in whatever fight you're in, you just have to press 4 and you don't even have to select any god to transform into them. It's really good if you know which god you're going to turn into for the next fight and you don't have to stop what you're doing with the wheel. So it's super helpful, but not everybody knows about it. Oh, Morrigan probably could have taken 2 buffs. I probably could have started at speed. I'm not going blind. I could have maybe stole that, but nah, we're not gonna do that. Where did he go? Oh, he went assassin blessing Xing Tian. It's funny because I just recorded a Xing Tian game. He must have got, based on the stacks he had when I warded him, I think he took speed buff as well. So now I need a, he's slightly ahead of me, but not anymore because I stole those. He is ahead of me in level. He is not very tanky, so I can just hit him. Kind of like when I'm playing Ares with Assassin's Blessing. You can't box in the wave. It's just not the same. As much as I want to get him here, if I ult, then he's gonna counter ult, and I don't want that. However, if I ult, I do get full mana. That is something about Morrigan ult that is awesome. If you're at low mana, but you have enough mana to ult, then you can use all the abilities when you transform, because you'll have full mana. Okay, that was weird. Yeah, that's the counter ult. This is so silly. That's so silly. Oh, am I gonna die? No, I'm not gonna die. We ain't gonna die. Oh, look at all those juicy minions. Look at all these juicy minions. Oh my god, he's so low. He's 1 HP. Oh, you better. Oh my goodness. You are so lucky. You are so lucky, Xing Tian. Count your blessings. Yeah, an interesting thing about Morrigan is her passive, it used to work super, super well with Hunter's Blessing. Like each tick, each damage over time tick would proc Hunter's Blessing, but they changed it, so it does still proc it, but it's a reduced rate now. Ooh, do I wait for 100 gold? Nah, I'll take speed. And I'll take blue buff. But yeah, that was kind of cool. You know, Morrigan's passive is way more than I thought it was. 9%? I could get away with an attack speed build. I think that would be fun. I think we'll go an attack speed build because it's more fun, plus it'll make the game closer. I like to have closer games. Because otherwise, if you were to try hard full sweat, it would just be basically invisible from one buff to another until you're so ahead that Xing Tian can't do anything. Xing Tian would actually still have some options against that, but it's a lot more difficult. And honestly, I don't think I want to do that. It's not as fun. Now I'll back and get Bankrupt. So I think we'll go attack speed build. And I mean, in a way, it is a good build because it's 9% of his health, right? And yeah, it's 9% of his health, and he's a guardian, so he's gonna have a lot of HP. So, you know, that's not too bad. Like right now, that's 90 damage. We're barely at the start of the game. Obviously, it's only every third auto attack, though. I shouldn't reset my autos like that. Oh, that doesn't work. But that works! Oh, I missed. Oh yeah, someone asked me last the Gene 10 video if I have that skin. It was a ranked reward. I do have it. Oh my god, are you kidding me? It switched targets to me! That tower switched targets to me. Oh god, at least he didn't get the kill. But it was a ranked reward. You can't get it anymore. It's an awesome skin. Next time I play Gene 10, I'll probably use it. Because people seem to like that skin a lot. I don't think Assassin's Blessing G10 is very good, though. I think Mage's Blessing is better. Because he couldn't even take both buffs before they went into tower. So I think just start blue buff with Mage's Blessing. Oh, man. Wow, that damage though. That damage though, he's out. He's gonzies. My beads are down, so I have to be a little careful. Oh, I should be fine. No, I'm not. Imagine saying I have to be careful and then I immediately get caught by his ult. That's actually hilarious. Cooldown. She's a Magi. She's a Magi. Let's go with cooldown. We do need some cooldown. Oh, is that? That was technically first blood, actually. Because first time I died, it was to tower. So he's actually winning by 100 gold. Okay, after this, I'm gonna go Shoguns, Demonic, Aces, like, and Telkines. I think that'll be fun. But I have an ult too. Oh wow, I didn't even have to ult. I didn't even have to ult, man. That's crazy. Good stuff, good stuff, good stuff. I do like maxing the 2 on Morrigan, although it really, in most cases, you should max it based on which ability is better of your opponents, because when you ult, that's going to be the level that you have their ability. So Jingtian's one's good, but his root's also super good for just CCing him in place. Good ult, because that got my beads. Pretty sure he's still. Never mind. That came up faster than I thought. Is one. Never mind. How much did that do to me? 600? That was using that ability twice, I'm assuming? There's no way that was using it. Well, maybe using it once. I don't have defense yet. It's possible. It's possible. Plus, obviously, Bankrupt's super strong. So he got some wards. I haven't really been placing my wards because, I mean, against Jing Tian, it's not like he could sneak Bull Demon very well. I mean, I would know better. Okay. We're actually ahead in gold, which is pretty nice.
Don't want to step on any jellyfish now, do you?
But I'll put the free ward to the left just to get a general idea of where he is on the map. Alright, he wants to ult me into tower. I can't let him. Can't let him do that again. Damn, that was so stupid of me. Should've used my 3 first. I just wanted to have an escape up just in case. That was such a bad engagement. But, I mean, we should be fine because now his ult's down. I don't know. Dead. He just has to use his 3. Yeah. I'm so dead. Where's his 2? Oh my lord, we got him! I had no mana too. He missed that 1. I mean, I don't know where his 2 is. I could have sworn it would have been up in time. I guess I have my Jing Tian cooldown, so my head off a little bit. Kinda nice. Besides the Assassin's Blessing, I do like his build though. I'm a fan. Destroyed a middle enemy
tower. Hey, can you put this lotion on my back already?
And can I get like a what can I get? Upgrade sprint? Yeah. Yeah. It's all coming together. What's my attack speed? 1.3? That's nothing. Speed buff gives attack speed. That brings my attack speed to a 1.38. Very little, but I think it's 10%. Yeah. 10% movement speed, 10% attack speed. Now we can go for Boldy if needed, but I don't think it will be right now. I do have beads, so I think I want to bait him into ulting me, because I can see it happening. I just need to ult right away. He's gonna ult? Maybe not. Oh, I didn't time that well enough. Oh my god.
Everyone look away. You saw nothing.
I wanted to time that ult perfectly so I could catch him at the end of it, but he used beads anyways. The rest of that was just staying in tower too long. I got rooted in tower and then I was just kind of in a bad spot. Jingmirs are weird. Like, when I turn into Jing Tian and it's a Jingmir, it is so different. 1.47 attack speed. So I believe about 13 of my passive ticks would kill him if you were to not include mitigation. Obviously, there would be a ton of more damage because of my other auto attacks, but that's kind of cool. It would take forever to get that, but it's kind of fun to think about. I'm not going for building right now, Jing Tian. I won't do that to you until it's necessary. Still have my beats up.
My revenge. I will find a way to have fun.
No, dig it, dude. Every time, man. Oh, if he backs though, I'm pretty sure, yeah, he's not back. The The attack speed's getting fun, though. Yeah, because he can... Because we timed the ultimate perfectly. That way I get the CC immunity and grab him. Is so... It has to be pretty much frame perfect, because otherwise he has an opportunity to jump out. And I don't really have any experience as Jean Mirror, so it's proving more difficult than I thought. So I don't have my beats up now, but we're not near as Phoenix, so we're okay.
My revenge.
He's still gunning for me? I came up fast. Oh god, that was not good. I'm dead. That tick damage, prevents me from, it prevents me from using my 3, because if I use my 3, I'll just go out of invisibility again, so I have to wait for it to be over, but by the time I wait for it to be over, he's right behind me using the ability. It's kind of hard to do any Morrigan invisibility tricks here.
Your middle tower is under attack.
What can I get? I got great beats now. It's pretty important to have. Wow, out of range, really? Am I actually gonna lose? Oh my god! How, his ultimate comes up so fast. He only has 20% CDR, correct? I don't know why he's not taking my Phoenix right now. This is your opportunity, man. You should take it. You should 100% take my Phoenix right now. I don't know where he is or what he's doing. But not taking the Phoenix is not good for him. Because you don't get those opportunities very often. Like there, he killed me at the perfect opportunity. He had pretty much a full minion wave. Right in front of my Phoenix. That can sometimes just lead to ending the game, straight up. I'm starting to think this auto attack build isn't going to lead to nearly as close a game as I had hoped. Pick Boldyman instead? Alright.
Am I still here?
He's doing way better than I thought he would. I really miss that. I can't, man. I can't. He has Crow's Pendant now. Oh my goodness, that was a lot of cooldown. And now my ult is down and his ult's gonna come up. Alright, got it back. Let's get Telekines first before Hasten. I'm not giving up. I'm trying my hardest right now. With this build, anyways. What's his power at? 385. Alright.
This is my revenge.
Good use of sprint. Oh god, that bracer! Oh, but my auto's chunk! Oh, he's getting gem. I can chase him here. Oh my god. Oh my goodness. These fights are so close. All right. We press on. I am very, I'm like, I would say lucky, but it is super, it's like really awesome that my sprint allowed me to stay out of his ultimate just barely. Because Jing Tian ult does give movement speed, but I think sprint gives the same amount, if not more, movement speed. So it's able to keep me out of it just barely.
Your team has destroyed a living enemy phoenix.
Oh my god, that comes up so fast. That comes up so fast, man. I wasn't expecting his escape to be up to that fast. Is he getting morphed now?
My revenge.
Take you down.
Okay, we're actually somewhat in trouble now. Right back. Okay, Acer Ring last item. And possibly a Toxic Blade after that. Can I get Power Potion? My damage is going to increase by so much right now just because of Telekines having more power and stuff like that. Yeah, I'll sell boots for Toxic Blade. That'll give me more mobility as well as just more damage or attack speed. 30% attack speed. Be precise.
Am I still here?
Have nothing up. Oh my god, his one didn't kill me, just barely. Just barely that one didn't kill me. Very nice. Man, GG. The auto attacks were doing, they were doing okay. The auto attacks were okay. It did make for a closer game and a more fun game though, in my opinion. I hope you guys enjoyed that. And if you have any other gods you want me to play or any other content you are looking forward to on YouTube, just let me know. And I'll see you guys next time. Adios.